It's gonna, this shadow is gonna extend down here and fade into the edge. It's actually a shadow that's on the egg, it's not in the background. It's like reflected light here, and then in here within the shadows, so we want to make sure that we identify that. Perhaps that's a little too light. So one of the things that's important to learn, I think, is that when you apply paint, you don't have to like slap it on. You can make changes in your painting very subtly, and just like in drawing, the biggest changes that you're gonna make are gonna be caused by slight changes that you make. So learning to sort of just tickle the painting a little bit is great. You don't want to, what one of my painting teachers used to call, tickle the painting to death, okay? You don't want to spend so much time just tickling. I say that, it sounds funny, tickling the painting, but just being very cautious and very light with your hand. One of our assignments towards the middle of the course is all about texture and brushstrokes. So first we learn how to control the paint, and then we learn how to lose control of the paint. That's my thinking. That way, if you come into a situation where you want to control the paint, you absolutely can. Alright. So I'll be back to my white. Bring out my purest light, actually. And here. And my reflected light down here. So when you're doing alla prima, everything is really wet right now. So what I'll need to do to really get that white nice and clean is I'll need to wait for the paint to dry and then come in and put that some darks in here too, actually. Put that white in. Think about, you know, this, I think about drawing, it's a dance. You have to find the relationships between adding and subtracting. Once we move into exploring brushstroke, for instance, we can start to think about the dichotomies that can exist between very smooth and flat painting and a more dynamic and visible brushstroke. So as I'm painting, you haven't taken drawing with me, then not heard me talk about squinting your eyes. You want to squint your eyes, and that pulls all those values together, allows you to see things more contrasty. Brushes. Use my bigger brush. Yes. sort of moving it up to a point now where I'm going to stop for the demonstration. How do you know when to stop? When it looks right.